great to be back here for my third year. My name's Andrew Rosenblum. I'm 31 years old, and it's a real pleasure to be playing Schubert's Trout Quintet for you, and to be working with such wonderful colleagues, Jiwon on the violin, Daniel on the viola, Thomas on the cello, and my dad, otherwise known as Bruce, on the bass. this is actually the first time that I've performed with my dad ever. So that's really special for me. And so we're doing something a little bit interesting, which is that we're going to play the first three movements of the quintet, and then we're going to present the song Die Forelle by Schubert, which Die Forelle means the trout, and then the last 2 minutes of the Schubert. So the reason we're doing that is that the fourth movement of the quintet is a theme and variations that uses the tune of Die Forelle. And so we want you to hear them back to back. And this is not normally done. They're normally separate works. But Schubert wrote the song first and then based the quintet on the song. So I thought I'd tell you a little bit about the text of the song so you have an understanding of the piece. So the text for the song was actually written by a poet named Schubert, not to be confused with Schubert. And it's told by a narrator who's watching a fish swim capriciously in this peaceful brook, and then he later notices that a fisherman comes by and is trying to catch the fish, but he thinks the fisherman will never be able to catch this fish as long as the water in the brook remains clear. So the fisherman waits a long time, is unable to catch the fish, and then decides to muddy up the waters, and instantaneously after that catches the fish. And the narrator is enraged by this act of betrayal and stares at the dead fish with raging blood. So that's the that's the poem. And although the fourth movement is the only movement which really draws thematic material in a very direct way from the song, I think that the whole quintet uses gestures and textures which evoke the capriciousness of the swimming fish and the peacefulness of the brook, and also even the stormy outbursts which might represent the moment when the fish is caught and is thrashing on the fisher's line. So I hope that you can hear that, and I hope that hearing these two pieces interwoven together will provide an interesting context for each other. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.